So here's my first piece I cut out of the leather. The leather luckily is thin enough that I was able to cut it with these scissors. They're good titanium blade, I think, scissors, and they're super sharp, so they're good for cutting this out. This leather is kind of a natural color inside, so that a little bit of that shows on the edge, so I think I'm going to take my marker, which I said I was using a Sharpie, but it's not. For once, I don't have any Sharpies handy. So I'm just going to color the edge of it in case this peeks out a little bit, which it might because my cutting is not perfect, but it's good enough for me. For a first attempt, not bad, and I think it's going to look very nice. So I have the bottom main piece cut, and I have my circle drawn for the hole. So again, just like the paper pattern, I think I'm going to take the utility blade and cut that out. Since my paper template, I traced it on here with a Sharpie, it's a kind of a wide line. The edge I want to cut is actually going to be the outside of where I drew the line with the Sharpie. This black leather, the Sharpie isn't the easiest to see, but I think I can see it well enough. We'll find out, and we'll see how easy or not. Nice thing is being able to just kind of rotate this as I go, so I'm not moving the blade as much as I'm just kind of rotating the leather in a circle to make a reasonable facsimile of a circle. And it actually looks like a circle. I think I still have stuff in the tripod socket. Shocking, from all that muck still falling out of there. So let's see how she fits. It looks like it's on there, but it seems that circle's not quite big enough. I'm not clearing. I can feel this metal bit is raised up just a teeny bit. I guess the thickness of the leather from the camera, that panel. So I'm going to have to cut that out just a little more. Let's see how challenging this is going to be. I'm just going to kind of carve out just about a millimeter maybe. Oops, went outside just a little bit. Let me come back in again. If I was left-handed, I'd come back at it the other way. Or I should say if I was ambidextrous, but I'm not. So now we have an elongated kind of circle. Not quite a circle, but it's one of those things that doesn't have to be perfect. Really, the purpose of the leather on this camera is to protect it and to cover up assorted holes. So let's see how she looks. It's sitting a little too low at this end, so I think I need to come out just a wee bit from this bottom section. It might actually resemble a circle a little more. I'm kind of doing a bevel edge on this too, because it's easier to hold the blade this way. And once I color the leather in, I think it will actually look pretty nice. And now that we're shaved down a little bit, it's centrally located. Get that little bit, extra bit that I didn't cut off, but there we go. Okay, so now I'll color the edges of the leather black and the inside of the circle. And I'll be ready to glue on. Here I have all of my pieces of leather laid out, and I have some adhesive sheets that I purchased. It's actually scrapbooking adhesive, which is acid-free, from the craft store. I believe I purchased it at AC Moore. So I'm going to pull the adhesive sheets from the packaging. I think there's about 5 sheets here. So I'm going to pull one sheet, which should be sufficient for all of the leather pieces. I'm going to pull that off, pull one side of the liner, and then I'm going to proceed to lay each piece of leather down onto the adhesive . And here we have the finished product. Once I laid the leather pieces down onto the adhesive, I cut around them and attached them to each section of the camera. It came out pretty nice and smooth. I figure with time, these little wrinkles and creases will lay flat. All in all, a pretty good project.